You ever lose your cell phone while you're making a video about ways that you can use your cell phone when you're painting?
Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Kyle Martin, and in today's video we're going to be painting this scene that's right behind me. We got the old farmhouse and a couple of sheds and that evergreen tree. And we're also going to be talking about five pieces of technology that I use for plein air painting. There's some really good pieces of technology that I use for plein air painting. These things don't have to be complicated or hard to use, and you're probably actually already using a couple of them, not even knowing it. One great tool to use is Google Photos. Okay, so all of my photos automatically upload to Google Photos, and this is the location that we're at today. If I swipe up on this, you'll notice that this location map pops up right down here, and that's going to give me a map of where this painting location is. And actually, if I click this open in maps right here, it's going to open it in my maps, and it's going to tell me exactly where it is, and I can just follow the directions and get directly to it. The next piece of technology that I use is this app called Lumos. Lumos is a really cool app that you can use to show what the sun is going to do. Today I'm going to be painting some golden hour light, but if I was painting something that was backlit, you can see here, it's going to show me where the sun is at and what it's going to do. It looks like at about 7:30, I'm going to lose my sunshine. So that means that I've got about an hour to paint right at this moment. You can also, like tonight, there's going to be an epic moonrise. I think it's actually a full moon tonight. And you can see that this, just by clicking this little button at the bottom, changes it from the sun to the moon. As a plein air painter, it's really important to be able to know what the sun is going to do. Lumos is an app that I use to figure that out. The final piece of technology that I use before we start painting is this app called Notanizer. I took a photo of the location that I'm standing at. At the top bar here, you can see that we have black and white color. So if we do black and white, we can see our image in black and white, and we can also see it in color. But of more importance is Notan, which is harmony between dark and light, which is two values. There's just a black and a white here. We can click three values. Now we're starting to be able to see this in terms of paintable masses. And I usually like to click on this fourth one, so I have four values. But this basically just posterizes the scene and lets me see it in terms of shapes of value. And I don't know how well you can see it on the canvas, but I have laid out the design of the painting to match what I liked in Notanizer. When you're in the app and you have it kind of at the value levels that you want, you know, you can move it around, you can recompose the thing however you want, but I decided that I liked it right there, and it's time to start mixing the colors. So while I'm mixing colors, I need to be thinking about the relative value for all the colors. You can kind of use your cell phone camera in mono mode or black and white mode to check the values on your painting. And go to a filter that's called mono. And now I can see my palette under a grayscale effect, so that when I'm mixing the color of that shed, I know that it has to be lighter than the soybeans on the ground. Here's the colors that I've mixed. Here's the color of the shed that is receiving light. So it's this mass right here, the lit up mass of that shed. And I'm just gonna use this color as the shadow side of that shed. I can check the value using my camera. Let's see, you just push the up arrow, and then there's this filters button. Click mono. And there I can see that definitely this value is lighter than that value. I mean, that's something that you could easily tell just by looking at it. But it is very helpful to use your camera in grayscale mode to check the values of your painting. Well, you can see that this is kind of laid in the same way that that real blocky, posterized, filtered photo was that we made in Notanizer. And you can see over here that the light is actually getting better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set up a different panel, remix some colors, and start a second painting, and then I'll come back and finish these up on another evening. You can see right there that the sun is about to go just beyond the horizon. These are my favorite moments to capture, these last rays of sunlight, and they don't last very long. Actually, tonight, we're not even necessarily getting those last rays of sunlight. It's being obscured by the horizon, but that's okay because I know the effect that I'm after because I have that little grayscale sketch on the app, and that can help guide me even at times when the sunlight is not cooperating. I can use these tools, but at the end of the day, right now, it's just going to take some doing to get this one placed onto the canvas. I'll come back tomorrow and I'll finish these up. Finishing up laying in the second painting of the evening, and I'm getting a feel for the shapes in this one. So much of landscape painting is abstracting the landscape into paintable shapes and masses of value and color. And right now I have this one laid in. The final piece of technology that I want to talk to you about this evening is using your cell phone as a mirror to check your work. Your cell phone, even when it's out of battery, is just a dark, reflective piece of glass. People have been using dark pieces of glass for centuries to check up on their paintings to make sure that there's no errors, as it gives you a fresh read on your painting. I've been out here painting for like an hour and a half, and that's really not that long, but the painting, it just starts to burn itself into your eyes and you no longer can see mistakes and things like drawing. Can you see the painting reflected backwards? And you can see the subject matter reflected backwards, which is really helpful because I can already see a couple of things that are happening here that I want to change. Normally I just go through and fix maybe the biggest 3 to 5 mistakes, or I mean they're not really mistakes, they're just things that need to be changed before the painting is finished. Kind of dart your eye back and forth the painting and the subject matter, and you can start to see what needs to be changed to make the painting more accurate. I'm going to work on those couple things this evening and we'll come back out tomorrow. We'll finish up this painting. Welcome back. We've got our second day out here in the beautiful Wisconsin landscape, and we've got these sheds over here and that house and that tree, and they're all receiving beautiful evening light here. in the last week of August.
I've got both the paintings kind of laid out. Oh, look at that one.
Look at those shapes. Good shapes. Notanizer app really kind of helps you find your shapes. I'm talking all about the way that you can use technology for your plein air painting, but when it really comes down to it, the best thing to do instead of using the Notanizer app is to do a grayscale sketch. Do it for yourself. That way you're making these decisions. I do use some of these apps in the painting process, but it's because I understand how to create those shapes of value on my own. So I normally do it with grayscale markers and just by doing a sketch on my own. However, if you are in a time crunch, it does save a few minutes in doing so. The trick is tonight is to just get these paintings finished off. Let's go ahead, let's set the easel up. Well, I'm so happy that I finished up these paintings because now I actually get to leave and I don't have to have these on the dash of my car anymore. This one especially, I think I was able to capture something of that golden hour light. Of course, I was painting very quickly and that's what I enjoy most is that chase when the light is perfect. Okay, the mosquitoes are so bad. I've had two mosquitoes fly into my eyeballs. I'm wearing so much bug spray right now that the only place that the mosquitoes can find a non-bug sprayed part of my body is to attack my eyeballs. So thanks so much for sticking with this one. I'm glad that we finished it off. We'll check in soon. Technology items that you can use while you're plein air painting. GoPro, stop recording.